types. So what we see here, we have four different types of the, like, backlight possible. So the most common, and I would say 95% or 99% of the TFT displays that we have on the market, they are just transmissive displays. Yes. So we need the backlight from the back. Then we have the LCD. Here it will be LCD TFT, of course, layer, and we have a screen surface and the viewer. So for transmissive, if you remember from our monochrome session, you need the backlight to be always on. If you will switch off the backlight, you will not see anything. Yes, but same as in monochrome displays, less popular for TFT displays, we have transflective displays. They are not popular because usually when you have a transflective TFT displays, the colors are very weak, so they are not bright. The display it's not very practical to use. Yes, maybe you can see the screen, but it's the application is limited. Some transflective displays are used by military applications where you care a lot about the power consumption, so you switch off the backlight, and maybe you agree to have the lower quality of the image, but you can still see the image. Yes, so the power consumption saving is the most important in some kind of application, and you can use the transflective display. Reflective display almost never used in a TFT, but there is one technology I will show you later that is called low power refractive display, is used in a TFT, but it's not very popular and it's kind of new technology, I would say. And of course we have reflective displays as a variation with the front light. Yes, so we can add the front light for the reflective display and have the image even without external light. But as I said, 99% probably TFTs are here and the rest is there, so they are way lower in numbers on the market. Okay, so here we have the display that is called LPRD, so low power refractive display. So this kind of display use the environment light, ambient light, to reflect and still can produce some colors. Of course, as I mentioned, the colors are not perfect, they are not perfectly clear, but this technology is getting more and more popular because it allows to have a color display in a battery-powered applications. Yes, so for example, a watch would be use case for that, or maybe electrical bike or like a scooter, electrical scooter, of course, where we can have some image and not only boring monochrome display, but the color display but without the backlight. So we can see this image even in a strong sunlight environment, and we don't need the backlight at all. So this kind of technologies are getting more and more popular when we have more outdoor displays and we need a low power displays. Okay, so here we have some examples. How does it look? So if we have the simple image here, that will be the pattern like that, you know, only black and white, then with the transmissive display, even with a 1000 candela, 1000 nit brightness, the image probably will be in a lower quality than the reflective display. Yes? Because if we have a sunlight, we have a very strong light reflected on the surface of the screen. We talked about it in a video about contrast. You can find the link down below. More details about that. So reflective display is a quite good for the outdoor. If we go with the lower brightness, of course, the image is even worse. So transmissive LCDs, as we talked before, they need a really high backlight. Yes, so 1000 and more to be really seen out there. Okay, so here we have, just to show you how it's built. So here we have the LCD.